Good morning and good afternoon to all of you. Welcome to my class. Today we are going to solve a problem based on Planck's quantum theory. Yes, note down the problem. Problem number 2.7. On the screen you can see the problem number 2.7, note down. So what was given in the problem? A 100 watt bulb. A 100 watt bulb. A 100 watt bulb emits monochromatic lights. Monochromatic lights. Monochromatic lights of wavelength of wavelength 400 nanometers. 400 nanometers. Calculate the number of photons. My dear students, it is the photons. Number of photons emitted per second. Emitted per second by the bulb. Emitted per second by the bulb. Very, very important problem. For 3 marks, it is very important. Yes, on the board, you can see the problem, same problem. A 100 watt bulb. So here I am taking a bulb. A bulb having some filament, right? Suppose it is considered as a 100 watt bulb. And the bulb is going to emit the light. The bulb is going to emit the light. The emitted radiations are having wavelength. Wavelength is indicated by lambda. Lambda is equal to 400 nanometers. So when the bulb is going to emit radiations, that radiations are having energy. And the bulb is having some power. The power, what is the power of the bulb? The power of the bulb is given as 100 watt. Once again, the power of the bulb is given as 100 watt. What is meant by 100 watt? How can we understand the 100 watt? How can we understand 100 watt? What is meant by watt? W-A-T-T, watt. Actually, it is called as watt. 1 watt is equal to, what is meant by watt? 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. Once again, 1 watt is equal to 1 joule per second. So during the 1 second time, during the 1 second time, if 1 joule of energy is released, then it is called as the efficiency of the bulb, that is 1 watt. How much energy is going to be emitted? How much energy is going to be emitted by the bulb? Energy emitted by the bulb, energy emitted by the bulb per second is equal to 100 watt. Sorry, not watt, 100 joules. Once again, the energy emitted by the bulb per second is equal to 100 joules. Why? Because means 100 watt bulb is given. Once again, 100 watt bulb is given. 1 watt is indicating 1 joule per second. So per second, the 100 watt bulb is going to emit an energy of 100 joules. So finally, we know the energy. E is equal to 100 joules. And we know the wavelength. Wavelength of monochromatic light emitted. The wavelength of monochromatic light emitted, lambda is equal to 400 nanometers. So from the data, what we know? Energy of the bulb is given. 100 joules of energy is going to be emitted per second. Hence it is taken as 100 watt bulb. And the wavelength of monochromatic light emitted is given in the problem, that is 400 nanometers. And we know the velocity of light or speed of light, that is a constant value. The speed of light is a constant value, and that is equal to 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. So all these three values are known. What we have to calculate? We have to calculate the number of photons emitted per second. We have to calculate the number of photons emitted per second. So to calculate the number of photons, which formula should be used? The formula is capital E is equal to small n into h nu. According to Planck's quantum theory, capital E is equal to small n into h nu. Here small n stands for number of photons emitted. Then number of photons emitted is equal to capital E by h nu, right? Small n, that is number of photons emitted, is equal to capital E by h nu. What is the capital E value? Energy of the bulb. 100 joules is the energy of the bulb emitted by h value. H value means Planck's constant value. The value is taken as small h means Planck's constant value. The value is taken as 6.6256 into 10⁻¹⁴ joules a second. Here, E means energy. Energy is the 100 joules into nu. Instead of nu, what we can take? C by lambda. C means velocity of light. Lambda means wavelength. So instead of nu, I can write C by lambda. C value is 3 × 10⁸. Meters per second by lambda value. Lambda value is given as 400 nanometers. Instead of nano, what we can write? 10⁻⁹. Instead of nano, we can write 10⁻⁹ meters. So once again, to calculate the number of photons emitted, small n is equal to capital E by h nu. Instead of nu, nu means frequency of emitted radiation. Nu is the frequency of emitted radiation. Instead of frequency of emitted radiation, we can substitute C by lambda. Lambda means wavelength of emitted radiation. So we are substituting all the values. Then we can calculate this one. Finally, we will get the answer. So this is the calculation part you have to do. So I'm not calculating here. Yes, write down this one. Otherwise, take the screenshot. Either you can write down. Otherwise, take the screenshot. Right. My dear students, I am sharing the answer. No need to worry. So on the screen, you can see now the answer. Yes, on the screen. Once again, 6.6256 into 10⁻¹⁴ joules a second into 3 × 10⁸ meters per second. Yes, see here. This is the numerator. This is the denominator. And this is the numerator. This is the denominator. Here, this is the numerator. This is the denominator. Denominator by denominator, that goes to numerator. So finally, we will simplify it. 100 × 400 × 10⁻⁹ meters. Here meters gets cancelled. Here per second get cancelled. Joules get cancelled. So if you simplify this one, If you simplify this one, you will get the answer. If you simplify that one, you will get the answer. Yes, on the screen you can see the answer. On the screen, wait a minute, I will share. Yes, on the screen you will see the answer. Just enlarge the screen. Just enlarge the screen like this one. By touching your mobile, just by using your two fingers, you can enlarge, you can see the answer clearly. So what is the answer given? What is the calculation? The answer is 2.012. 2.012 into 10 to the power of 20 second inverse. Here second inverse is indicating per second. The second inverse is indicating per second. So per second, how many number of photons are emitted? The number of photons emitted per second are 2.012 into 10 to the power of 20. So these are the number of photons emitted by which type of bulb? These are the number of photons emitted by which type of bulb? If the bulb is 100 watt bulb and the bulb is going to emit a monochromatic light of wavelength 400 nanometers, the bulb must emit only a wavelength of 400 nanometers. Then only we will get the number of photons 2.012 into 10 to the power of 20. Suppose if the bulb is not going to emit, if the bulb is not going to emit 400 nanometers wavelength of radiation, if the bulb is not going to emit 400 nanometers of wavelength of radiation, what will be the number of photons? What will be the number of photons? Whether the number of photons remains the same or the number of photons emitted is going to be changed. Once again, my question, if the wavelength of emitted radiation is not 400 nanometers, if the wavelength of emitted radiation is going to change, whether the number of photons emitted changes or not? Whether the number of photons emitted changes or not? Text me your answer. Whether the number of photons emitted changes or not? Yes, the number of photons changes. So what is the relation between number of photons and energy? What is the relation between number of photons and energy? Yes, see here, the relation between number of photons and energy. The relation between number of photons and energy. Number of photons and energy are directly proportional with each other. So whenever the energy of the bulb increases, the number of photons emitted also increases. Right? And now, if I am going to take the relation between number of photons and the frequency, number of photons and frequency, number of photons is inversely proportional to frequency. Whenever an equation is there, equal to means this is indicating an equation. So the equation on same side, if different types of values are there. This is nu, this is h, this is n. Different types of values are there. They are inversely proportional to each other. Whenever equal to is there, opposite sides of equal to. What are the opposite sides of equal to? E and nu are the opposite sides of equal to. Then they are directly proportional. Yes, all of you know this is a basic concept. Whenever equal to is there, the opposite side units are directly proportional with each other. The same side units are inversely proportional with each other. And here I am saying that number of photons is inversely proportional to, one by means inversely proportional to frequency. And we know the frequency formula. Frequency is equal to the frequency formula C by lambda. Now, substitute nu here. Instead of nu, suppose if I write C by lambda. Yes, now what is the relation between frequency and wavelength? What is the relation between number of photons and wavelength? What will be the relation between number of photons and wavelength? Now, what you can say, my dear students, here I'm writing, nu is going to be replaced by c by lambda. Then I can write the formula, lambda e is equal to n into h into c. Is it correct or not? Is it correct or not? Text me. Is it correct or not? Is the formula is correct or not? It is a conversion. Here, instead of nu, I am writing C by lambda. And lambda is taken to this side. That is lambda E is equal to N H C. Now, I am going to take the relation between number of photons and wavelength. What is the relation between number of photons and wavelength? What is the relation between number of photons and wavelength? What is the relation between number of photons and wavelength? Because both are opposite to each other. When two quantities are opposite to each other in an equation, they are directly proportional. Anyhow, our concept is, just a minute. Here our concept is, which type of bulb is given? 100 watt bulb is given. 100 watt bulb means, the bulb is going to emit 100 joules of energy. That is called as 100 watt bulb. And if it is going to emit a light of 400 nanometers wavelength, then it is going to emit number of photons are 2.012 into 10 to the power of 20 per second. Second inverse means per second. So this is all about problems related to Planck's quantum theory. What is the formula of Planck's quantum theory? Capital E is equal to small n into h nu, right? Yes, my dear students, I am going to move to the next topic. The next topic is photoelectric effects. Just a minute, I will share the screen. Photoelectric effects. The topic is photoelectric effect. For your convenience, I am writing the notes every day. I am sharing with you. I am sharing with you the screen. Within 1 minute, the screen will be open. Just give me a minute. Yes. Photoelectric effect. What is meant by photoelectric effect? How can we understand the photoelectric effect? Yes, just a minute. Yes, my dear students, on the screen you can see now some diagram is given. Yesterday night I tried my level best to make a diagram. Just touch on the screen. Just with your two fingers, you can enlarge your screen. So here, to understand the photoelectric effect, first of all, I am taking this one. What is this one means? A metal surface is taken. The yellow color line you are seeing, that is a metal surface. So onto the metal surface, this is the surface of the metal. See here, surface of the metal. Onto the metal surface, whenever a light is going to strike, this is the striking of light, falling of light, striking of light or falling of light onto the surface of metal. Light is a form of energy, and light is nothing but electromagnetic radiation. Electromagnetic radiations are having wave nature. So wave nature means they are having some frequency. So light is having some frequency. So the light with some frequency is going to strike on the surface of the metal. So when the light is going to strike onto the surface of the metal, then what is going to happen? From the surface of the metal, this is the indication you can see now. So from the surface of the metal, ejection of electrons is going to take place. Ejection of electrons. Ejection of electrons means removal of electrons. Yes, all of you know about solar panels. Yes, see here. Suppose if it is considered as a solar panel, onto the surface of the solar panel, when the sunlight is going to strike onto the surface of the solar panel, what is going to happen? Light is going to be converted into electricity. Once again, when the sunlight is going to strike onto the surface of the solar panel, the light energy is converting into electrical energy. So this is called as photo. Photo means light. Photo electric. Electric means here electrons. The light is converting into electricity. That is the photoelectric effect. So to understand the photoelectric effect, first we are taking a metal surface. Suppose if it is considered as a metal surface, onto the metal surface, what is going to strike? Some frequency of light is going to strike. So when the frequency of light is going to strike onto the metal surface, from the metal surface, ejection of electrons are going to happen. So when the electrons are going to be ejected, if the ejected electrons are going to move through a metallic wire, then electricity will be produced. So this ejected electrons are going to have some, the ejected electrons are going to have some kinetic energy. But before that one, this is the form of light that is going to strike onto the metal surface. The light is having some energy. And suppose here electron is there. Suppose the electron is there on the surface of the metal. This electron is holded on the surface of the metal with some energy. Once again, the electron which is present on the surface of the metal is holded with the surface of the metal with some energy. To remove this electron, what is required means some minimum amount of energy is required to remove this electron. To remove this electron from the surface of the metal, some minimum amount of energy is required. That energy is called as threshold energy. Threshold energy is indicated with E naught. So whenever a light having sufficient frequency, when the light having sufficient frequency is going to strike onto the metal surface, from the metal surface, the electrons are going to be ejected. But before ejection of electron, some part of the energy of the light is used to remove the electron. That minimum amount of energy which is used to remove the electron, that energy is called as threshold energy. And the remaining energy of the light is used to move the electrons from the surface of the metal. Once again, the remaining energy of the light that is used to move the electrons from the surface of the metal, that moving energy of the electrons is called as kinetic energy. So finally here, three types of concepts are there. One is the total energy of the light striking on the surface of the metal. And the second one is threshold energy of the electrons of the surface of the metal. And kinetic energy of the electrons ejected from the surface of the metal. So here we can understand the photoelectric effect as, what we can understand here is the photoelectric effect is nothing but when sufficient frequency of light is striking on the surface of the metal, ejection of electrons is going to take place, is known as photoelectric effect. And the photoelectric effect mathematically represented as E. E means the total energy of the light striking on the surface of the metal is equal to E naught. E naught means threshold energy. What is meant by threshold energy? Threshold energy means the minimum amount of energy, used to remove the electron the minimum amount of energy used to remove the electron from the surface of the metal. From the surface of metal. Once again, E naught means threshold energy. Threshold energy is defined as the minimum amount of energy used to remove the electrons from the surface of the metal is called as threshold energy. And the remaining part of the energy of the light, the remaining part of the energy of the light, that remaining part of the energy of the light is used to move the electrons. Moving electrons having energy is called as, moving electrons having energy is called as kinetic energy of the electrons. So finally, we can write the mathematical formula. The mathematical form of photoelectric effect is written as capital E is equal to E naught plus K. E naught means threshold energy defined as the minimum amount of energy used to remove the electrons from the surface of the metal, and KE is the kinetic energy of the ejected electrons. Yes, my dear students, text me about this one. Text me about this one, whether it is understood or not. Text me in the chat box. Yes, already I sent the PDF also. Once read the PDF. Whether it is understood or not. Photoelectric effect. Yes, okay, okay. Thank you for your response. Once again, in a simple manner, I am writing the formula. Photoelectric effect is nothing but conversion of light into electricity. Nothing but solar panels. The principle involved in the solar panels is photoelectric effect. And the simplest mathematical formula is written as capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. Here, capital E is the